For today, we're going to be moving into what we call two column proofs. So we're going to be asked to prove something. So question number 63, give a deductive argument to explain why the side PT is congruent to the side RT. Okay, so which sides are we talking about? PT is this one. RT is this one. And I'm supposed to say that one side is equal to the other. Kind of look the same, but in geometry, kind of looks the same. Doesn't quite work. All right, so first of all, I'm gonna see what I'm given. I notice that angle one is congruent to angle two. Congruent means same shape and same size. I also know that angle five is congruent to angle six. We're gonna call this two column proofs because on the left side, I'm gonna have statements. Right, statements are what I just said. Angle one is equal to angle two. Angle five is equal to angle six. But then on the right side, I'm gonna give a reason. And I always start with the given stuff. Right, that was given. You guys see the markings? Okay. My next thing I'm gonna say the side QT. Or actually, I'm going to say angle five plus angle three is equal to 180. You guys see angle three is right here. You guys see angle five. But at the same time, I'm going to say angle six plus angle four is equal to 180. You guys see those? Here's angle four, there's angle six. Now, two angles that are equal to 180. Didn't we call that linear pair back in the days? Notice for my reasons, I always capitalize the first letter. Okay, so I have that angle 5 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. Good. Angle 6 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. Good. Now, I'm going to say angle 5 plus angle 3 is equal to angle 6 plus angle 4. Right, on the linear pair, I got that angle 5 plus angle 3 was 180. Angle 6 plus angle 4 is also 180. So they're both equal to 180. So can I just say they're equal to each other? Yeah, we call that substitution. You might be like, what? Take a look at this phrase. Angle 5 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. I just replaced 180. I just substituted 180 with angle 6 plus angle 4. Why? Because I know they're equal. So that's why I said I call that substitution. Okay, so I might need more space here. Now, remember how we said on the given part that angle 5 and angle 6 were equal? So I can easily just say, let me take them out. So I'm going to get my next statement. Says angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Now, how is it that when we take things out because they're equal, right, there's an equal sign and we take them out from both sides. Remember that one? Isn't that subtraction? When we subtract two things. Coming back to the picture, I'm like, all right, so I know angle three is equal to angle four. Nice, I just know that now. But there's a side, I want us to focus and take a look at this side. You guys see I highlighted the side QT. Now, Let me write this thing out. QT, side QT, is congruent to the side QT. Might be like, well, it's the same side. Yeah, but didn't we learn yesterday and the day before that when one side of two triangles is shared, we can just mark the side and we call that reflexive. Reflexive theorem. The theorem is basically the other word for rule. Reflexive theorem. Okay, so let me come back to what we have here. Let me highlight a triangle. Let me highlight a second triangle. I think I can say those two triangles are equal. Because look, angle one is equal to angle two. Angle three is equal to angle four. And now I have this side in between marked. So I'm going to say, let's see, triangle QPT. That's the yellow triangle. It's congruent to triangle QRT. And the reason why, I see I have two angles in the side in between. Angle, side, angle. All right, so let's see. I was supposed to say that side PT is equal to side RT. Now, one rule we're going to learn for today, very important rule. Once I say two triangles are congruent, once I say two angles are congruent, so here, this statement here, I come out with a bunch of statements. Now, I can say, do you guys see my writing here? I can say the side QP is congruent to the side QR. Notice I use the first two letters of one triangle are equal to the first two letters of the other. I can also say side PT is congruent to the side RT. I can say that. I can use the second two letters. I can even say side QT is congruent to the side QT. So I can come and say the sides of one triangle are congruent to the sides of the other. I can also say that angle QPT is congruent to the angle QRT. So one angle, one triangle is congruent to the other. I can also say angle QTP. Notice the order of my letters is congruent to angle QTR. Once we say two triangles are congruent, I'm gonna say that three sides, there's one more statement I can come out with. I'm gonna say that three sides of one triangle are congruent to the three sides of the other, and also that three angles of one triangle are congruent to the other. So therefore, I can say, let me complete here, I can say, the side PT is congruent to the side RT. I can say that. Now, let me mention the rule for you guys. You guys see how you guys abbreviate in your text? You guys sometimes abbreviate IDK. Yeah, you guys know what that means, IDK. OMW, you guys know how to abbreviate things. Now, in mathematics, we also abbreviate things. Now, the rule we're going to use is a long name. So I'm going to abbreviate it with initials. Right? I can come up with all these rules that I said because the parts, the corresponding parts of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding parts of the other triangle. So I'm going to say corresponding parts of a triangle, corresponding parts of triangles, corresponding parts of congruent triangles, I mean, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Okay, so let me say that again. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. All right, that's the whole name. I'm just going to abbreviate it as CPCTC. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Okay. Now, one thing I want us to emphasize. This last statement is the one I wanted to prove. You guys see that? The side PT is congruent to the side RT. That is what I wanted to prove, so I'm done. All right, let's take a look at number 64. Take a look at number 64. So again, I'm gonna do a two column proof. On the left, I'm gonna have statements. What I mean with statements is something is congruent to something else. And on the right, I'm gonna have the reason. I have to explain everything. Use the diagram below, discuss how to prove the side AE is congruent to the side BD. Okay. One thing that I see is that angle ADB is congruent to angle AEB. You see that? That's the one with the two slashes. I said this angle is equal to this angle. Another thing that I know is that angle EAB is congruent to angle DBA. And I'm going to say that I know because they were given. They were marked to begin with. I also know that side AB is congruent to the side AB. Right? I'm using the same letters. So I said that is called reflexive theorem. Notice I capitalized the R. Now, I want you guys to take a look at one triangle. And then let me mark the side AB. I'm going to say now the triangles DBA is congruent to, you see that triangle that I colored? Now I want you to take a look at another triangle. Triangle DBA is congruent to triangle EAB. And I know because that's angle, angle, side. Now I'm gonna say side BD . Notice those are the first two letters of one triangle. Sides BD are congruent to side AE. And I know that because corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Now that's what I wanted, right? AE is equal to BD. Same thing as BD equals AE. I'm done. Make sure on your reasons, notice I capitalize the first letter of each.